first, I just wanted to say, real quick, I just want Wanda and I to say a few words if we can. But before we do that, we just want to first just thank you all who came out tonight. And if you're here, you're very special to both of us. So Wanda and I sat down to do this. When my wife Patrice came up with the idea to do this, I immediately went to Wanda and then Lamoris, and you know, we decided to put this thing together. I've learned that it's very important to celebrate each other all the time. Because I've seen so many people who we thought they were gonna be here tomorrow, and then tomorrow comes and they're not here. So Wanda has always said this to me for 20 years, like, give people their flowers before they die. And it finally got in my head, and so we came together to put this together to celebrate a very special occasion. So obviously a lot of you all know I came back to V-103, where I should have been, where I probably shouldn't have left. But as the prodigal son story goes, I had to go out and see the world. And Rick Caffey, who I'm gonna bring up in a second, will tell you, he was like, are you sure? Well, I'm gonna give you my blessing, but are you sure? And I said, yeah. And I found out the world wasn't what I thought it was. And I came back, so they graciously brought me back, and Wanda graciously accepted me back into the show. And since we've been back, things have really changed for the better. And I'll just say this, and I'm gonna let Wanda talk. Many people thought that the landscape had changed so much. And this is the funny thing. When I left V-103, it was December of 2012. It is now 2018. That's how long it's been. And in that 5-year span, the landscape of Atlanta has changed. There's so many more people who have moved in the city and who have come to the city. And it was like starting over, but then when we got on the air, it really wasn't like starting over. It really was like a natural thing that brought us together. And we've got some amazing results that, you know, we'll talk about a little bit later on. But first, my partner in crime, who really is, like, outside of Larry Tinsley, is probably the longest standing person at V-103. She gets her 20 years, you know what I'm saying? You know, so, honestly.
Like Frank said, thank y'all so much for coming out. If you're here, that means that you mean a lot to us. We sat down and came up with the people that were there with us from the very beginning, people that mean a lot. Of course, there could be other people here, but you were chosen. And thank you so much for sharing this moment with us. Of course, I've been here for a very long time, and it's just, I guess, you know, sitting down, I've had challenges throughout my years, but if it wasn't for this man right here telling me to keep pushing and keep moving, don't worry about it, I don't know how I would have made it. Of course, Rick Caffey is telling me you are here as long as you want to be here, so I believe you. since 1998, it is what year is it?
20.
Wow. So big round of applause for that. Longevity. V-103 is my home, and I feel very comfortable there. And I always keep in mind when I wake up every morning, I'm getting people to work that may not like their job, that may be having a hard time getting to work. Some people that may not be making good money, having a hard time on the job or with their families or what have you, and I always keep that in mind, that we're helping people get to a place that, you know, they may not want to go to. Always keep in mind that people need to laugh in the morning. People need to get the education in the morning. We're like the radio, the newspaper for everyone. Sometimes we don't read the newspaper, so we try to give entertainment. We try to be funny. We try to, you know, give love, affection. We help people when they need help in the community. So I just want to say thank you once again, and of course to my husband for always being there for me and making sure I'm good, waking me up every morning. I don't want to get up. He has to beg me, believe it or not, one, please get and so thank you so much for, you know, helping me through it all, because it is, you know, it's been a long journey, but I love what I do. I love people. So getting back with Frank and of course Miss Sophia, we have definitely, you know, jumped back into the saddle like we've never been out of the saddle, and we know, we're moving because we're supposed to be there. What God has for you, nobody can take it away. We're supposed to be there. You're supposed to take that away. You're supposed to go out and see that it wasn't for you. I asked Kathy, I was like, why did you let him go? He's like, I can't stop him from going. I got to let him go out there and see. But in my mind, as a woman, you should be like, you know what? I really want you to stay. I really don't. I need you. But I see that ain't a man. That is not a man's thing, right? So he let Frank go out there and just kind of hang himself. So welcome back, guys. Welcome back, guys. So it's fun. I'm still having fun. I'm still having a good time. Of course, you know, our team with Maria, Miss Sophia, you know, Reggie, the whole crew, you know, Mark D, everybody, Noni, Patricia, that all bring it all together. I really appreciate it because it is hard getting everything together. But thank you all so much for being a part of this journey. Thank you all so much. I can't say thank you enough.
Thank you. All right. So one thing I want to shout out Maria Boynton, our news director, who, man.
And Stephanie.
And she is the bomb, Stephanie Saltworth, our traffic director. Joe is here, aka Miss Sophia.
Yeah.
So if you get up in the morning, it's been an incredible journey, and I'd really like if our vice president, general manager, Mr. Rick Caffey, would come up and say something.
So, how smart am I to reunite these two
people? Yeah, yeah.
Well, first of all, it's a natural continuation of that journey. I mean, Frank kind of talked about the fact that he had to go away to come back, and I understand it. I mean, that wasn't going to try to squash anybody's dream because you gotta go out there because life, it's taught us anything, it's very, very short. So you don't want to live this world, this life with I coulda, shoulda, might. So I'm happy that Frank is back. I'm happy that they're reunited with Wanda because it is a natural fit. And the nice thing about it is I have two pros here that really get that concept of the people station is that it's not about Frank or Wanda or Rick or Intercom. It's about all of you here and at large. That's why we named it the People Station, because it's about serving our community, serving the people, bringing them every day entertainment, you know, information, and occasionally we get a chance, although he does it twice a day, inspiration. So thank you to Frank.
Thank you.
Coming back, you go, thank you, Wanda, for never leaving home. All of you here, you know, good friends and, you know, people that I see and know and recognize and everything, and for all the other ambassadors out there that are the fans of our radio station, that, you know, please tell us, you know, you're the boss, you know, keep us on track, you know, because we're here to serve this community and give it our very best. So thank you.
Thank you. So real quick.